I just started it. 4 seconds of video.
We did the whole thing and he go, I don't think I got anything.
So, hands always here for travel.
Right. You lock it down with a chain.
Change the safety chain. But the head itself is still locked in place
where it's sitting on that.
On the rest pin. So it ain't going nowhere. Alright. Tell you what, Rob. You grab that fender on that side and I'll grab this one off.
Alright. What?
You'll see there's a couple bungee cords there. Just push down the bungee cords. There you go. Just pick it right up out of there.
Alright.
And we'll set it right here on the front of the middle. Is always work opposite the head. Now we want to get the mill close to level.
It doesn't have to be.
It doesn't have to be perfect level.
Right.
Most time what I'll do is I'll just kind of look at my water bottle, give me a pretty good idea about how it's sitting. All right, turn the key switch here to position 3. That's the accessory position.
Okay.
So that's kind of like in the old days, we sit there, we turn the key backwards, listen to the radio, but we ain't doing nothing with the motor.
Right.
Now my hydraulics are in their travel position. So I gotta get them out of travel position. But I can only operate the hydraulics when the head's at that end of the mill.
Okay.
So we gotta raise the head up to 26 inches and that'll clear all this stuff. You just gonna pick up right there and hold it. There you go. And put 26 inches behind that small line. Now reverse is what's called a dead man switch. What that means is when you hit reverse, you've got to maintain pressure on it.
Okay, when you
if
stop,
you let go,
it
stops.
Okay.
So what we're gonna do now is we're actually gonna take the saw head to that far end of the mill. Just pick it up there, press it, hold it. Go bump, bump, bump. There you go. Now actually what the mill did actually kind of picked up this back end a little bit.
Right.
Now
so sitting on these three legs.
Sitting on these three legs here. So now we'll come back and drop these back legs down. Just don't let it drop on your foot down there.
You're picking up both of them.
Don't finger in them holes. Now the book will tell you get equal pressure on all your legs. I always tell people to me the two most critical legs are the end legs. Especially longer material you shove, because you don't want this mill going like that as you saw. Alright, so I want to move the leg down and the mill up. We'll come in like so. Like that.
You see, locked in.
Locked in. Now, this is the rest pin. This is where that head was sitting.
Come out.
So, yep, we're going to pull that out. Hold that down.
Good.
Now I want to be able to find this later, what I do with it.
Put it back in there.
There we go.
Yeah. I have to do that on mine.
Sorry. All right. Now right here, these are called velocity keys. So all that basically means is if a line breaks, it keeps you from free falling. So I want to show you how to unhook this, because grab this chain right here right now.
It's tight.
It's tight. Okay. I want to show you how to do it where it's easy on your body and the machine. So come up here to the front.
First lever on the right.
First lever on this side, raise it all the way up.
Yeah, I did watch a video the other night that said they go in order of where you use them.
Yeah. Now the third lever, here you go to bypass.
Yep.
The third lever from the inside, there's two functions. This is going to be your side support and then your turner. Raise that one up so everything quits moving. Keep coming. There you go. I'm going to do it first time, then I'll have you do it. I'm going to lean my body up against this guy. Pull this claw back to me. Free that chain up. And then I'm going to ease this down to the ground. If I hadn't extended those feet, I'd have had to take it all the way down the ground.
Right.
Same thing when I fold it up, do just the opposite.
All right, Rob, go ahead.
There you go. Ease it down.
The camera's moving.
Now, put that last lever down. Now, right now, we're pulling all the energy from the battery. You really don't want to just continue doing this because you're going to weaken your battery to make your alternator work harder to catch up. Put the third one down and
that'll lay back.
That's it. Alright, then over here, come over here, John.
The battery is
right here.
Right there, okay. That'll work.
Look inside there, you see the little fingers? The fingers are there for safety.
So I don't get my hand up.
So,
okay.
Can't stick your hand
in. Stevens, hold one, please. Stevens, hold one.
Blade breaks, chunk of wood.
Right.
Now, safety always has the good side, and then it has that pain in the butt side. So, pain in the butt side is, if you don't have sawdust coming out here,
you gotta raise
that it. Means that's staying inside there.
Right.
So I'll keep me a little stick in here, and I'll clean them out if I need to.
Right. Take that off and open it up.
Yeah.
Okay.
And a leaf blower is a good thing at night to get down with this thing.
Okay.
All right. We're set up. We look at our water bottle. Pretty close. Okay. That just makes it easier on this little motor to pull it back and forth.
Right.
Now, on this mill, if it's metal and it moves, I want you to spray it with transmission fluid. So, these slide pads here, these chains here,
okay.
Up and down here,
okay.
That arm, the power feed chain, if it's metal and it moves, spray it with transmission fluid.
Okay.
The reason we do the transmission, it cleans and it lubricates.
Right. Right.
Now you do have grease fittings on the mill. Each one of these pivot arms got one, right here on the side.
Okay.
Each side support has two, here and here.
Next. These are the optional ones.
That's the optional ones. Okay. Yep.
What about with the rollers?
No, they don't come with those. Them? No.
Okay.
And actually, when they come down here, they'll actually be in the way. You got one here on your clamp, two on your turner, and three on each pin on your roller.
Okay.
All just metal fitted. So, sheet of grease, watch it come out.
Right.
All right. Let's go through a blade change. You know how to fold them and that kind of stuff?
No, but I've seen them and I probably want gloves when I do
that. Okay, I got some trainers here. Let me do that.
Okay.
I love folding them bandsaw blades. Working the machine shop.
You flip them like
yeah.
That.
I'm going to pause it for a minute.
So, get ready to unfold them. We'll put your right hand. You're going to take the top one off and let it go and hold on to the other two with your other hand. Whoa, now. Go back. See, mine crossed up here. Let me catch it with you. Don't. Take an extra one off the top and let it go. Oops. Hold on. Now, take top. That's it. Now hold it now. Keep a hold of it there. Let that hand go. Now turn your hand up this way. All right, now. I got it in my right hand. I'm going to hold it in my left hand here. Left hand and two fingers. Then I'm going to slide my right hand back to this one. All right, hold it with there. Now, there you go. Just open it up.
Wow.
All right, now the easiest way to fold it, come up here, put your thumbs on the outside, and you're going to snap and roll. See how I'm making it go flat right there? You almost got it. You got it. There. Going in. Going like that.
Yeah, I think it does. I knew there was a...
All right, go ahead and go back to it again one more time. Top one off. Just take the top one off and let it go. All right, see, now I'm free. You're crossed up, so put this one back on the bottom. Take the next one off. Feel that difference?
Okay.
All right, knuckles up. All right, now hold it with your left hand and two fingers. There you go. Slide your right hand back to that one. Boom.
All right.
Snap and roll.
Boom.
There you go. Yep. You almost had it. That's it. Whoops. Now you can invert a blade. You go ahead and pop back. See how it's almost twisted inside out on you?
It is. There we
yep.
Go.
All right. There you go, just like that. Once you just can't let it, once you take control, you can't let go.
That's going to take some practice.
Now, the easiest way to do it for the real blade is put your teeth up against the end of your log like this. Just pick up, make it flat right there on top.
Right. Hold that up.
And definitely make gloves.
Yeah, gloves and safety glasses.
Right.
All right, let's do a real blade check. So come over here to the control box. Push it in forward gear, it's gonna lock in place. And because in forward gear, you're gonna control the load on the motor by how fast you make it go. So you control that speed with that knob.
Okay.
So go ahead and turn it up, let's take it down to the other end of the meter. See this pin? So when I'm going down the highway, the debarker can't swing. So as I pull this out, this little plate's only purpose in life is a place for you to put that pin.
Okay.
All right. Two things very important. One is a clean blade's a happy blade.
Right.
You got to keep that blade gum. You can't let that blade gum up on you. Because if the blade gums up, the blade gets wider than the teeth and it can't steer. So you'll start throwing blades off, you'll start dipping and diving.
I've seen them put pine saw or...
Pine saw, Dawn dishwashing liquid, laundry detergent. Just don't be chintzy on your soap. If you're home washing dishes and the dishes ain't getting cleaned, you put more water or more soap? Same thing here. Okay. Next thing is good blade tension. So over here on this side, but this bolt here is your gauge.
Okay.
All right, so you want the inside of that bolt and the inside of that washer there in line. If you get home and you forget, there's your picture.
Okay.
Now, when you pull that handle back to you,
hop out of here.
You want to keep your palm on this side.
Okay.
Don't grab it like that.
Because
if you do, it's going to pop
you in the head.
That's it. I can pull it down a little bit more. There you go. Pull it back to you. All right. Now, let's say I wanted to put, go ahead and throw it back up there with normal tension. Now, if I want less tension on the blade, let's say I'm changing it. Go ahead and back it off. I'm going to screw this full shaft in here, and I'm going to make it shorter.
Okay.
All right, now.
Is there a gauge on there that tells you how much?
That's
just that. That's
that bolt.
The gauge. Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right, go ahead and throw it back up there now. You see, you feel that difference.
Oh, yeah.
Feel that difference? Okay.
A lot lighter.
Okay. So then, if I'm going to put my tension back on it, I'm going to open
that
this.
Orange. Door.
Well, you're not going to know until you apply pressure, though.
Okay.
So go ahead and now tension it back up. Yeah, feel that difference back in?
Mm-hmm.
And then look, inside, in line.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right. Detension it. There you go. Now we're going to pop the doors open. Pop the door open the other side. Now, I usually bring it down this end to change it because I ain't walking around a bunch of stuff, but
right.
I push it back too far. To change the blade, just open the door. Yeah, there you go. And I just kind of grab a figure eight. But now you do have to come out around your D-bar.
Right.
So. Go back in. What I'll do, I'll get on this side over here first. Now I push it back about 1/8 inch off the front of the wheel, like so, between the gullet and the front of the wheel.
And
it will
wheel
subtract.
Tire is loose.
Uh huh.
Okay.
So that's what your blade's actually riding on, that belt right there.
Right.
They come with this belt here, exact same belt. So if you want your tires to last long in your truck, what do you do? Rotate. There you go. Right. So that's my drive side, this is my idle side, so that side's gonna actually wear more than this side.
Do you do that with every blade change or every other blade
better 50
change?
Hours.
Okay.
The belts, a set of belts will run you, we're generally last about 150, 200 hours. Okay. Now sometimes you gotta reach in here and pull this belt up below that, and then just flush it up with the back.
Okay. That's all there is to it.
I see you handle changing the blade. Okay, go ahead and tension it back up. Now, I mean, normally you're just going to throw tension on it and go to saw. I'm actually going up. So right here, this is my main drive pulley. You got this pulley over here, you got this belt that your blade rides on. Don't worry about it being loose.
Yeah, then you got another one back here.
Then you got a middle groove, that's your brake pads.
Right.
And the back two grooves are your main drive belt.
Okay. That's what goes to the engine.
So I had a customer one time who said, oh, it's like you turned the lawnmower deck up this way. And it's like, so I said, makes sense. So I'm not gonna crank it. I'm just gonna pull this handle down over here and you watch the movement here. So you'll see the blades come off.
Right.
And then your drive belt get tension.
Right.
And on that side, I'm throttling the engine up and throttling it down.
Right.
Now, the biggest thing that'll have to do, Rob, is so like, if you let this get clogged up, sawdust ain't coming out here. The sawdust is going to get underneath
there,
this back inside.
And that's going to jump and the belt comes off.
There you go. Right. And the other part is it'll sound like this blade's just, this bearing here is coming to pieces on you. What else? You're like, what in the world's going on? Pull the blade off, pull the belt off. I usually spray it down with some penetrating oil or something and clean that groove out.
Okay.
All right, so what I'm going to do, let's close this up. I'm just going to clean the engine up just a little bit just to track it. I can do it by hand.
I've seen them on, you can do it by hand in there.
Well, what I'm gonna do is I'll usually just come in here and
I'm gonna go over and turn it on.
No, we're good.
You got it right here.
I just kind of pull it down, get between my brake
right
and my drive belt. Kind of freewheel a little bit.
Just to make sure everything's rolling where it needs to.
That's it, yeah.
Right.
But now, I only do that if I'm looking for something. Everything's going cool. I just changed the blades. I'm just going to put it on and go.
Right. I've seen them online do that with the doors open.
Yeah.
And just reach up here and turn
it.
Yep.
That's it.
All right.
That's good.
And see, that's moved.
A little bit, it kind of tracked it.
Yeah, it was actually forward on the belt and now behind it.
Yeah. And then, move on the side over here. Oops. There we go. That looks good. Move that along. Alright, so come over here back to your control box. Let's give ourselves a little. Now, as long as you get down below 12 inches, that stuff comes into play. There's no physical interlock to stop you from hitting.
Right.
Now, since we're above it, we're good. Now, when I come backwards, what I generally do is I'll turn this way and hit reverse and walk this way with it.
With it.
Yep.
But I need to be above 12, so I'm at 13 and
yeah,
I
Yeah, so you're
I'm
good here. Now.
Is there a bottom track on that? You talked about
ATF
on there.
Bottom side, I don't ever really mess with a whole lot.
Okay.
But there it is. Yeah, it does ride up. There's another one of the cam power bearings on the inside there.
Okay.
All right. On your gas. You don't have a vented gas cap anymore.
Okay.
It vents here back through the tank.
Okay.
So if you're going to park it for a while, go ahead and turn this off.
Okay.
Run it in.
Run it till it burns off.
Yeah.
Okay.
And as much as I can, I'd encourage you to run the non-ethanol gas or that's fuel perfect. Stabilizer.
I do that with my other equipment.
Okay.
So.
All right. Engine oil drains here, 10W30. About 100 hours on the change intervals.
Yeah,
filter here. Yep, there's your hour meter there. All right, let's go ahead and crank it up. We can go back to position one. Come on, go ahead and turn it on over. There's the idle position. Alternator's going to recharge the battery. This right here is going to be your thing. That's going to actually have to kind of wear in a little bit. I'll go ahead and pull it down and get it properly.
How wide a cut you do.
On your guide bar, when somebody's just starting, the most important thing I tell them is don't bang it into crap.
Right.
Okay. So, let me get that weld out of here. We talked about some alignment stuff. All right. So, but see your arm here, like if you move it in,
right.
See how your blade is actually going
behind,
downhill
right.
A little bit?
Right.
So we actually got down pressure with those rollers there. But if you start hitting this arm on logs and create movement here, then that's going to create movement in your blade guide system.
Right.
So I just tell people, you got a tapered log.
It's fixable, though.
It's fixable, yeah. But I say open it up enough to clear all the way down.
Right.
You get a square edge over here, and you want to bring it in within a couple inches, that's fine.
Right.
A good sharp blade overcome a lot of stuff,
Right.
But good blade tension, clean blade's a happy blade. Let's swing this big barker out of the way. All right, let's go ahead and go through your other hydraulic controls. Your first one, clamp in and out, press down the way, up and in. Okay. You see how that's moving down?
Yeah.
That's why you always travel with it all the way in. There you go. All right, the deck comes up, and there you go. And back down. Third one we've done. Now that's the only one that's got two functions. Now why do I want my side fork to come up before my turner does?
So you don't roll it off.
There you go.
All
right. Then your deck front and your rear toe boards. That's for leveling a tapered log.
Okay.
How do you move it back?
Push first one down.
This one?
Yep, down.
Okay. So once you get it in.
Yeah.
And the second one. Okay. That'll work.
Now your side forks here is obviously how you're gonna get your right angles to your bed.
Stephen hold one, please. Stephen hold one.
I want to see a gap at the bottom. Because I'm actually going to push up against it when
the rollers.
Well, just my logs and my clamp.
Right.
So I kind of hedging my bets a little bit.
Right.
Now, like today, in a minute when we saw a log, I just want you to pay attention and make sure you turn that flat side flush up against it.
Okay.
Now, over time, just from logs hitting these things, they're going to lean back on you.
Right.
So this is what your adjustment looks like. You'd actually loosen this nut here on the back side.
Right.
And you can put a 3/8-inch pull handle in there. Twist that that way. That pulls this down, pulls that top back over.
Okay.
You see that, John?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Go ahead and lay these down about halfway for me.
Third one down.
1, 2, 3. That works right there. All right. bring your saw head forward and come right over top of my feed square. Go ahead and lock it to your turn. Push back to the left and step to the back. There you go. Now your scent work has got to boot up, but it'll go ahead and go forward. Okay. Now this is your blade guide tool. I'm gonna show you how you have to go. Just pull that finger in a little bit. Get it out of your way. Now come out towards you for me. All right, so the first thing I want to show you is what's called saw head tilt. All right, I want to have you lower the blade down and give me just a little bit of daylight above my speed square. Give me a little closer. Bump up. Ooh, hell yeah, good job. All right, see that right there? Now look out here. What happened to it?
Well, you got tilt down because of your
guide. The blade's going this way, and it's going to torque down.
Right, right.
So for a day, just remember that 1/16 of an inch high is normal.
Okay.
Now, as this mill wears, this is going to drop down. And people start messing with these bed rail bolts down here. So you see all the adjustments on all these bed rails?
Right.
Leave them alone.
Right.
You just tighten this one about a quarter turn, and pick it back up.
Okay.
Point okay. Those again in case I missed it.
This one and this one will pick up the saw head.
Okay.
Tilt the saw head back up this way.
So you want that 1/16 of an inch slope over that spin.
That's it.
Because it torques will flatten it out.
Torques down.
When you turn it.
Right.
Now this right here is your blade guide tool. This actually makes my blade appear wider so I can see how my blade is running front to back. I always want to put it on in between the teeth because if you look across your blade, every third tooth you'll see a down point tooth and then up point tooth.
Right.
So we're going to allow 1/8 inch for this blade. It doesn't take up quite that much, but we're going to allow 1/8 inch.
Right.
Take my same speed square. All right, push the saw head forward for me a little bit. You can either push it or it don't matter. What's your weight? There you go. Now raise the head up. This one here. There you go. Good. All right, back down. Woo. Bump down just again. Bump up. Woo. Come on up just a hair more. That's it. I'm going to call that, that's kissing it right there, right? Then I'm going to pull the head back. And check at the front. It may be down a 1/32, so I'm gonna leave that alone. Now, my wear point here is this roller.
Right.
And when this roller wears, it's gonna wear thinner on this outside edge.
So that will get more noticeable.
It's gonna come up.
Okay.
So, and the book will tell you check this about every 50 hours.
Right.
All right, when you see that, and then what you're gonna do is you're actually gonna loosen this top, tighten the bottom, push up on that shaft to make it back flat. Or just about a 1/32 or so downhill is the way I like it to be.
Okay.
And then I come out here and I do the same thing on this side. 1/32 there. Go forward. Same thing, 1/32 downhill.
Right.
All right, so put that back in your box. That one's yours. If it's metal and it moves, spray it with what?
ABS.
There we go. Right, now then, I gotta read numbers. Because I need to know that this blade and that scale are telling me the same thing. All right? Which one do you think is going to be the boss, the blade or the scale? The blade. That's why I talk to people about my cheap table saw.
Well, is this not magnetic? Part of this
that is your quarter scale.
Okay, quarter scale is made one of those.
Quarter scale is magnetic. Now, the inch scale is just like your tape measure.
Right.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure from the bed rail to the bottom of my down point tooth. Just a little bit more. Right here, right in this area. You don't have to. It's a sawmill, you know, so. Uh, That's pretty darn close right there.
Pretty close.
All right. Now, if I needed to adjust it to the sawyer's eye, I could take that loose and I could slide that up or down to match the saw blades. The indicator.
Okay, the indicator came in there. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Loosen the screws and move it to where
that's it.
Plus, if you got a 6'5" sawyer versus a 5'10" sawyer.
That's why you tell me my wife is 5'1" and a half. Or, I tell you what's going to be more common to you is you set up and the ground's low or the ground's high.
Now I'm looking down at it.
Yeah. So I try to get in the habit of just kind of looking straight at it myself. All right. So, let's talk about set work.
Okay.
Right now we're in manual mode.
Okay.
That simply means up's up, down's down.
Right.
Let's go into our set work. Press that button one time. Right now, set two is set to do a 1-inch drop. Press it again. We got them both set to do a 1-inch drop.
Right.
All right, press down one time and release. Down to 11. Now your next cut's 10, so you come up. Now you can come up as high as you want to. So like if you're leaving lumber stack, and you press up as many times as you want to.
You go up and then come back, and then when you hit down once, it goes down to
the next cut.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Now, the worst thing you can do this mill is not have that blade that past the log and hit down. There you go.
Right.
Right. So that's what I call a whole crap moment. Yeah. All right. So let's raise the head up to unlucky, about unlucky 13. Press and hold.
There you go.
That's good. Now, let's say you hit down. Oh, crap. Pull up. That's all you got to do. Now look what it did though, kick you back
into manual.
So you don't know where, it doesn't know where it's at anymore.
Right.
Okay. Yeah,
simple set and back into where.
So you go back into it and start over.
Okay.
Now that, obviously we're not always gonna touch 1-inch material.
Right.
So like today we're gonna cut a full 1-inch board, so I need to drop 1.8 inches. So press that up two times.
That.
Mm-hmm. All right, now for me, if I'm cutting all 1-bys, I just set them both to the same. That way, no matter which one I go into, I'm right.
Right.
So press that button there and take it up twice.
Okay.
All right, let's talk about your quarter scale. So how many quarters are in an inch?
Four.
So between each of these four quarter marks is 1.8 inches. Why is it 1.8 inches?
Because you include the blade.
Include the blade.
Right.
So 1-inch board. What's 5 quarters then?
It's 1.5 inches.
Nope.
I mean 1.25 inches.
6 quarters?
It's 1.5 inches.
8 quarters?
2 inches.
2 inches.
Yeah.
So what this does,
2 inches and whatever they put.
It's a speed rule,
right.
And each one of these blocks is your board.
Right.
So like today, we're going to cut some 1-bys down to the bed. If I set this up here, and I line that bottom four up with 1 inch, it'll tell me where I got to start off at, so that my bottom board ends up at the right thickness. And I waste that cut on my slab cut instead of down on the bottom of my can. That make sense?
Yeah, well, and you could turn it where your flat's on bottom and work your way back up.
Work your way back up. So what that does, it keeps you from having to count up to where you're going.
Right.
All right.
So your waste or whatever ends up not being the same is on the bottom.
That's it. Now, for me, I always think about it this way. Until I put a flat side down, I'm not locked in anything. Once I put a flat side down, I always think about where I'm trying to end up at.
You want, if you're cutting 1-bys, you want to be 1 inch off the
bottom. Or if I'm cutting an 8-inch wide can, I want to be, if I want to finish it, wherever I want to finish up
right.
at on that side,
right.
Once I put a flat side down, I count up from there.
Right.
All right, so if I want to come out of set works, hit the hand.
All right.
Now your water here is just straight gravity flow. Set your flow there. And then Nathan had us add this secondary valve to it. That way you can kind of set your flow here where you get it going like you want it.
And then it comes out over
and
here.
And then just turn this on and off right here.
Right.
Not the perfect system, but it works good.
You don't have a pump to mess up at that
Simple.
Point.
Simple.
Yeah.
All right, what'd this handle do?
That engages your blade.
All right, let's play with your debarker a little bit. Turn your debarker on. Nothing's happening.
Okay.
Go to forward gear. That's when
and all the lights come on and the blade
spins. Alright. Come back out of forward gear.
Yeah. It'll automatically roll up.
That's what's up.
Yeah, okay.
So that loads it up. And you just want to bring it into it, and if you got a limb or something that's coming out right there,
it'll go out automatically.
Well, it'll do some, but I would tell you if it's a bad cutoff, swing it out and then back into it. Okay. If you get in a situation where you're like, dude, my blade ain't turning. It's that little sign, attention, circuit breaker located inside.
Right.
It's kind of, you raise the head up, you see it, a little push button breaker,
okay.
But you can trip it if you put too much bind
on
it. All right, so as far as where's the head have to be at to operate the hydraulics?
Operate the hydraulics?
Yeah.
Above 12?
No, we're back here.
Well, I was going to be back here on this end, yeah. Right.
So see your battery's here.
Right.
That red wire, watch what happens when I come back on that strip right there. Right there, I can operate hydraulics.
Okay.
But the head's got to be back here.
Nice.
Hydraulic system, automatic transmission fluid, not hydraulic fluid.
So in the hydraulic system is ATS.
Inside the hydraulic system is ATS.
Okay.
All right. You want to
stop?
That's me alone.
Can I pause it?
Yeah.
My house.
Well, you're working off the end that's your final down there. You're not working off the smaller.
It's a small end here.
Right.
So this is your leveling.
Yeah.
Well, you okay. One at both ends, it'll level.
Either end. Okay.
You want to level the tip at either end so that you can ultimately cut that out of the log.
So you're talking about leveling the center line?
Or the tip here.
Okay.
So the reason you do that way, when you get through, you want that tip all on the same board.
Right.
3x3 or whatever you end up doing, how you do it. But I like to slide my clamp out. That way, if I need to, I can raise that clamp up and give them a quick little backstop. First one down, all the way in. Other first one, all the way to the other end. All the way in, there you go. See how those valves are proportional?
Yep.
All right, now, raise your loader up. Pick it up.
There we go. It didn't move when I first did it.
Alright, ready that second one up from the inside. Whoop, put that one down. Yeah, put that one on down. That's the last one. There you go. Now raise your second one from the inside up. There you go. That's good. Now you're going, if you're doing a big log,
yeah.
See how this arm here, right here?
You got to lower this back down.
Put this down about halfway. Just get it down below the bed. Come on now. That's good. That way, if you let your log roll back on you, it'll come down into that cradle still all the way back down on the ground.
Right.
It also gives me a place to put my edging boards as I'm sawing.
Right. You just push them off onto that.
Yeah.
Now I need to drop my
let's go ahead and crank it up a little bit. Yeah.
Does that need to be choked again?
I don't think you need to. Got to wear in a little bit right there. Alright. Go ahead and turn it. Raise that third one up. Let's hold it a little bit.
little curve to it.
Yeah, if you start the curve right from either angle, whether it be up or down, you know. But we want to get our boards going that way. Because you can't straighten a board, but you can nail it down flat. Does that make sense? Now, so like your side boards, I'd probably lower them down a little bit. I bring my clamp in first, kind of close by, take that second one up. There you go, come on in. Bring that first one in, not quite all the way. Don't pass it just yet. There you go, now lower that third one down. Come on. Well, that's it right there. Now raise that first one up. Done. Now, toe board.
That's where you're going to measure.
So, go ahead and take your 7.5.
Well, here you go.
Quarter. Okay. So we're within an inch, but if you
want
to pick out front end up a little bit,
that'll
be fine.
About a quarter of an inch.
Yeah. Half an inch. Now you may have to bring the clamp in up to it.
So then you look back. About 7.5.
Okay.
And if I get over.
Now you probably move that. Sometimes you'll move that far end down.
8. So you're about a half inch off.
All right. So go ahead and go forward here. Let's get close. Turn that up.
Okay,
now, let's add speed up. Now you On the step bed rails and not that hydraulic cylinder.
One, please. Cart total one.
All right, so now then, he's off when you clamp a little bit with that first one down. Now range the third one up. And you can either go 90 or 180. Stay on that third one. There you go. Remember how we set those side port squares in the bed? So you can flush it up over there. Bring your clamp in about halfway up your rod. There you go. There's one up here. Drop that third one back down. And the side port can come down a little bit, as far as you need to clean that edge up. Third one. Down. Alright. That looks good. Now, you flush on this side over here. Okay. So now then, just get you a new start point. And you kind of go in slow, and then pick your speed up. Rotate it. Okay. Now, top here. Whenever you put a flat side down, you want to put as much cord on your log as you can. So what they'll do, they kind of stop the log from being able to move down as you saw.
Right.
All right, so if I had this log sitting here and this ain't underneath it, and let's say I'm cutting one bys all the way down the bed, then it's just gonna continue to move down. All right, so we're gonna make our one bys this way. So I'm actually gonna cut on that 4/4 scale. So let's lay these down far
all
enough.
The way.
Well, this is far enough to
hang right here.
We're gonna hang a little bit, but just come down about halfway is what I would do. Now, as far as speed like, I always feel like take extra time when you're squared up.
Right.
Because that's going to translate to everything that you do. Keep going. All right, golden rule. Always make sure that this clamp is lower than these.
Okay.
Bring those back up. Come on, back up a little bit more with them. Third one up. That's good. Now, second one down. And then first one in. First one up. There you go.
That's going to be, I'm going to have to learn which.
Now, what, if you come in with that clamp high, there's two reasons. One is it'll push it up.
Right.
The other thing is you can't always see that clamp.
Right.
But I can look here and tell how much wood I got above my side port.
Right.
So if I get in the habit of keeping that lower, then I'll know I'm going to clear that clamp.
Right.
Without, because you got a big butt log up there, you're not even going to see that clamp unless you're on that side.
Right. Well, that's why at this point I'm
now
particular attention to go back over and make
the, sure. So right now, remember I made our marks on our board this way?
Right.
Indicating me that I want to do one bys this way.
Right.
So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to use my 4/4 scale. So go ahead and go to four here. There you go. Turn that up. All right. So I got my bottom four lined up with 1 inch.
Okay.
So I just get on a 4/4 mark, any one of them you want to get on. And I usually set mine up a little bit on the fat side because sometimes it's a magnetic pickup. And so if I keep it there, sometimes it gives that little extra to catch it. Set your set works, do 1 1/8 drop. And then I just hit down because I see a cut a lot. There you go. And then we're set up to cut one by all the way down to the bed.
Okay.
All right, now the thing is though, when you crank it,
it's gonna go
back into manual mode. Then go back into it.
Or if you get this set when it's in the simple set board.
Yep. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna set up here, and then I'm gonna have you flip it 90 degrees, and then we're gonna set the width of our boards on that other side. All right, you know what we're doing?
Crank it up and run water and
yep. Cut down, and then if I got a good square edge over here and my cant looks pretty symmetrical, if not, I'll drop and get me one more board, you know.
Right.
Okay.
No, you're fine. I just watch where I'm going from now.
Plus engine eight.
Thank you.
off of the first one. Raise the side forks up in that third one. All right, slap one down. First one up. There she is right there. She's locked the second one up. Come on up with it first. Get it kind of leaning first. Now that second one. Come up. Now, second one first. Let's get it. Now, lay the side fork all the way down. Drop that cement jig about an inch thick. So I want half of it below that edge over there. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Lean closer. That's it. Now, can you do that with my eye? I think that's all the pretty spots.
About a half an inch,
right? All right, so now then you're back on your four-quarter mark. If we want to do our four-quarter mark, you're probably going to get, look at the beard up there. Come up and see it. There you go. All right, go ahead and hit that quarter first. Not to worry, go ahead and hit that quarter first. Now you go back to your foot.
Right. I
want to
go down
and get a beater.
It'll be there. That's right.
Now, sometimes you've got
stress
in the log. You can leave them laying there. Yeah. So I'm gonna leave them laying there. You make sure you come up to at least 9 inches before you come back. Okay. Right, down one more time. If you want to come up to 10, I don't care. But now you're just going to go one after the other. One. You cut that whole thing up. But just don't come back until that blade goes. This, I don't know if this is getting the blade yet. As long as you can just come up before you come back. Don't use it. See how your quarter scale works?
Right.
End up the right cut at the bottom. Yep. Thanks.
there's always a little bit of chatter in it.
Yeah, it's good. I mean, it's a sawmill, you know. It's not a... Right. Now, your feed, like, if you're cutting seed or something...
Right.
You know, a lot of times guys call in with cedar and they're like, it's chatter. And I have to tell them to speed up.
Justin, you did it in the shop.
I like that cut there, though. The way your speed there, you run that.
Right.
Justin, don't call at the moment.
I am impressed. Y'all gonna use that for pallets, right?
People use it for different things. A lot of times guys right here doing like board and batten on a barn.
Oh yeah.
Good for that.
I got it.
I need about 10 of those 8x8s 10 feet long to build me a backstop for my shooting pit out back.
That's up to you if you want them. I don't care. He probably cut you some.
Oh yeah.
Did good, Rob.
That's 20 years of watching videos on YouTube.
Well, how does it compare to watching video and actually doing it?
There's a lot more detail in actually doing it than what it is.
The guys that do that for a while make it look easy.
Yeah.
Alright, go ahead and raise your side fork up about halfway.
Raise what? Loader up. All right,
slide your clamp out. Push the first one down. We're going. Okay. I was going to move them over, but. Set first one down. Second one up. First one up. Down that first one up. Alright, put this down back down about halfway. Alright, lower these down. A little bit more. A little bit more, still on that third one down a little bit. That worked. All right, give it a cut, second and a half. Raise the clamp up, first one up. Give me a cut at 7 and 6. I get your Sitting after travel.
Right.
There you go. end of her log, right here in her parking spot. So how high did we have to raise the head to when we first set up a few hours, a couple hours
it's
ago?
On there, 12, isn't it?
26.
26. Okay.
Raise it up 26, that clears all this stuff right here. You need this mark to be on your side. That'll be a line you up right there. All right, about another 2 feet, 1 foot, 2 inches, right there. All right, start lowering the head down. It's tight. There you go, you got it. That thing, as I get older, my depth perception, man, it gets. Now, go ahead and bring it on down to where it says stop. Okay, okay, you had it there. See how it kicks over?
Yeah.
All right, so that's locked in. Turn that off, put that key in your pocket.
That's the last thing I need. That thing rattle out while I'm driving down.
Yep.
Yeah.
Now, leave the blade tension on while you travel.
Okay.
But like if you're done sawing at night or you get home, I just pop the handle down. That way, it ain't sitting under all that pressure all the time.
Right, right.
Now,
with light stretch.
Well, it will, but you'll that stay on that bush and stuff. Uh-oh. We got to raise the head up a little bit. Put the key back in.
What did that go through?
Not there in the hole. You didn't put it back in the hole.
Oh, okay.
That's why I held on to it. I just know what it means. Where's that?
I'm like, why is that pin bent? Oh, okay.
That makes sense. Drop it and do something.
I'm going to put these keys and my tractor keys together.
All right. We got boot up manual. That's good. Now let's see here. There we go. Do I need to come on up with it?
Yeah, probably.
Let me take it. Let me just raise it up also. That way, it's in the tension.
There we go.
There we go. Sometimes it's still tight. Yeah, see, it gets kind of worn in. Sometimes I'll take my jack handle if I need to and tap on it a little bit. All right, we're locking down?
Yep.
There we go. Pull that in, snug it up.
Oh.
Now, so that's one safety lock. What was the other safety lock?
Yeah, the other safety lock at the back.
Okay, let's do that. Come around this side.
Yeah, that safety lock is on the chain.
Chain, there you go. This isn't going to bode well going down the highway, right?
So that goes back up.
You can either, I like to take this and hook it up back here on the front of there.
It won't vibrate up. Wouldn't it?
All right, you grab a fender, I grab a fender. They are interchangeable, but run them with fenders on. That way, if the tire blows out, it'll protect like these lines and that harness over there. And keep you out of trouble with the law.
You gotta have a fender on through.
All right.
Yeah, you don't have to have a tag to pull this thing down the road?
It depends. Like, some people look at it like a concrete mixer or a trailer with a firmly affixed engine.
A farm implement.
Even in Alabama, most time I've never seen a guy in Alabama have one on.
Yeah, that was my question on the way over here. It's like, uh-oh, I got another trailer I got to.
Now, I can't tell you, I haven't seen people just pull a tag off another trailer and All right, so like these two legs here are kind of pain to get to. So I just come up here with my front leg and I'll jack it up.
And now the weight's off of there.
Whoop. If John wasn't a busy bit, he might grab the bottom of that. Yeah. Like, hey man,
he assigned me to video, not help.
He's the video man. So.
I've never been a videographer.
Turn your gas off. They like to tell you to travel with the gas off.
Okay.
If you forget, turn it back on when you get home. It'll let you
know. It won't crank.
Yeah. It'll crank. It'll run a little bit.
Now, you didn't run that dry, though.
No.
So, tonight, when we get through tinkering in the yard, we're going
to... Well, I only run it dry if you're going to park it for a month. A week or two.
Parked for
months. All right, so inside
of
here is your manual.
Okay.
I'm going to have you sign this thing a little bit and say, Tim can't tell you everything, read your books.
Okay.
So you're getting the sawmill, HSS and debarker. The 10 degree is going to be your all-purpose blades. The 4 degree is going to be your hardwood blades.
Okay, and I've got a lot of hardwood on the ground right now. So.
And so we'll get those hooked up. We're going to do your paperwork with you.
Hey, Wade's calling you.
Thank you.